We're up now. Whoa. Welcome, Grand Final Day. How are you, Ray?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Ray McCoy and...
Craig Power.
And we're here at Dungowan for the Grand Final of the 2022 Group 4 Rugby League Grand Final. We've had three cracker games already. We're only moments away from kicking off the first grade Grand Final between Dungowan and North Tamworth. Welcome along, Craig.
Thanks, Ray. Yeah, no, it's been a great day so far. The weather's, the sun's coming out every now and then, and it's pretty windy, but it was good to see Gunnedah win the juniors and also Dungowan take out the Ladies League Tag.
Yeah, if you've only just joined us, of course, the Ladies League Tag was a golden pointer. And in the second half of that extra time, Dungowan 12 defeated North Tamworth 10. Always some rivalry between those two teams. In the under-18s, Gunnedah 28 defeated Farron North Tamworth 20. In what was just a cracker reserve grade game, Craig, Moree 22 just edging out Dungowan 18.
Yeah, absolutely. Moree have been probably the standout team in the reserve grade in the semi-final series, and they've done really well to get here and then take out the day. It was a close game. Dungowan actually looked like, you know, they might get the ascendancy there for a while. They scored a couple of tries in a row and led by 12 points, and you know, Moree just, you know, took their chances when they come.
As we lead into the start of the first grade game, Craig, from a Group 4 point of view, great to see Dungowan not only enhancing their rise up into the first division, but also you've got all the teams competing today being very, very competitive. Dean Moree coming down from up north to come down and participate for the last couple of years, and even with COVID and all those things, there's some quality rugby league today.
Yeah, I think so. I think it was a really good, you know, we were approached, the Group 4 was approached early this season or last season if Moree could join the Group 4. And as the boys just run on now, the Dungowan team running on. But it was good to see Moree invited back into Group 4. Great to see him in the Grand Final.
I know that clubs are made up of a lot of people. From a Moree point of view, Todd Mitchell, been there, done that for the last... I think he's just had his 80th birthday, but Todd...
Don't say that. I played with Todd, against Todd, so don't say that.
You build a good club around good people, and they do that. So whilst we're doing it here, I'll run through very quickly. The Dungowan team has just been announced to go out to take the field. Number one is Trent Taylor. Number two is Brock Morgan. Number three, Tavita Pekili. Number four, Brandon Parry. Number five is Liam Mack. Number six is Ethan Enzackles. Number seven, Matty Wilson. Number eight is Brett Jarrett. Number nine, Ryan Ingram. Number 10 is Jason Allwood. Number 11, Josh McLaughlin. Number 12 is Pat Lange. Cody Burns at number 13. Clay Frendon at number 14. Zach Parker, 15. Lockie Collins at number 16. And Sean Ferguson, the co-coach, at number 18.
Yes, well, the strike weapon of the team and their coach, Sean Ferguson, 17, eh?
He's very smart. Now we move over to North Tamworth again. Been there, done that. Number one is Yuri Jaffa-Williams. Number two, Ashton Constable. Number three is Mizali Vakalu. Number four, Jeremy York. Number five is Damien Scott. Six is Ethan Collins. Number seven, Mitch Sheridan. Number eight is Jake McManus. Number nine is the captain, Scotty Blanche. Number 10, Ben Jarvis. Number 11, the vice-captain is Josh Smoodle. Number 12, Jake Voss. Number 13, Kobe Bone. Number 14, Liam Ball. 15 is Jake Bennett. Number 17, James Cooper. And number 18, Tavita. So coached by Paul Boyce, and of course the coach, or the co-coach out at Dungowan, the man himself, Lukey Taylor.
Yeah,
righto, mate, game on. We've had some changes.
We have, in his first grade grand final, Luke Shooter on the sideline.
Okay, we'll see how we go from there. Again, hopefully if you're on the ground and you're actually watching on your phone, stick with us as well. All right, Craig, who's got the kickoff?
Yeah, North are kicking, and they're kicking into the wind. Actually, a strong wind today, Ray, and I think it'll play a big part, especially knowing both the key players, Sean Ferguson and Scotty Blanche, two of the key players in Group 4 of Northern Vision in the last sort of 5 to 8 years, and yeah, they'll use the wind to their advantage.
Righto, Craig, we've had kickoff time, and... it's Dungowan in possession. They're about 20 metres out from their try line. We'll bring you the action as we see it now. If we get excited, that's because it's going to be an absolute cracker game indeed. Just while we're doing that, Craig, brilliant crowd on hand. I know there's been a record gate coming through, and now the sun certainly comes out shining.
Yeah, I just love these bush footy fields, mate. It's great to have it out here at Dungowan, and for these guys to have the opportunity to put it on at a bush footy field, and the crowd's great, so...
We've got Kev Anderson hanging around here as well. And, mate, he did go to everything, including the opening of a can of drink. So Kev's here as well. Mick Smeedle's just behind me as well. I think we're in for a bumper game. Sean Ferguson starting the game, Craig.
Yeah, I thought he would, mate. He's way too important to sit on the bench and watch it at this part of the game. And definitely while they've got the win with them, he'll use full advantage to that, I think, Sean-O.
Well, Tavuta going through. There's been a changeover now, loss of possession. It's now North Tamworth in.
Oh, Jake Voss just got smashed in possession. A big tackle.
Welcome to the game, champion.
Welcome to the game, Jake. Good shot by Cody Byrne. Kobe Byrne takes a good strong hit up. Kobe Byrne's been great in the last couple of weeks. He's got a bit of aggression with him, but he's a good player. And unfortunately loses the ball.
Again, congratulations to Luke Sheather doing his first Group 4 Rugby League Grand Final in the middle with the whistle. Craig, your view before we get stuck into the game. Experience on one team, Dungowan coming up from second division up into first grade. Without predicting the outcome, how do you see the course of the game?
Look, I thought, I think in the finals, I was surprised how strong Dungowan were, but it was a couple of key things that a couple of the key playmakers done that changed the game over at Norths and sent through, sent them straight to the grand final. They've got a nice young team, but a couple of really good, strong, experienced heads in the game. Norths, on the other hand, have got a little bit more experienced players with Blanchy and guys like Josh Schmiedel out there. And look, it's going to be tight. I definitely can't predict a winner today.
I'm just watching the last couple of games, or the last half of the season. Certainly, Norths have played themselves into some finals footy. Dungowan, on the other hand, have got the smarts. Their two co-coaches have got the brains trust running all the time. One on the sideline, one on the field. They've produced some very, very good football. Sean Ferguson rubbles the ball through. Benny Jarvis has got it. And again, North Tamworth in possession. They're only a matter of 7 metres out from their own line. Certainly a matter of test the patience of both teams now and the referee to see what advantage they can get. North Tamworth bringing the ball out. Jake McManus. Coming out wide for the first time, been to Josh Smoodle, come back in towards the centre.
Bit of a stumble there, mate, but that's a good set coming out. Got to nearly to their 40. Hopefully Blanchy will get a kick in, but he doesn't. He throws it wide. Half break by Damien Scott down the left-hand side, and he's just lost the ball, and there'll be a changeover straight away. Dungowan's ball on the 50 metres.
We're up and running.
Good afternoon, Michael Smeedle. How are you looking today?
Well, don't ask him how he's looking. He'll tell you he's looking absolutely brilliant. But
I've been accused of being a cowboy today with my hat and everything, but no, I've just come up to watch the footy and you throw me out this. But anyway, it's a bit of a tentative start, but by sides.
You've been hanging around waiting for a yarn all day, so don't give me that. All right, Tavita down the sideline. A great break from...
Great break by Tavita. Oh. He's made it. He's got his way through Yerby and he'll score in the left corner. Tavita Purcelli.
Well, there's some of the unknowns. We've had the influx of some new players come into both teams this year. Again, we've seen
Dungowan scored by number three.
Yeah, definitely that try looked a bit too easy, actually, the way he got through there, mate. The defence was a bit weak on North's right-hand side.
His play before, he actually took the ball through and dropped the ball, so from a mistake he's picked up and remedied that for the try. Mick Smeedle.
Tex had actually enjoyed that try because he played with North Tamworth last year before the competition was finished. So he quite enjoyed that because there was a little bit of chewing and froing when he decided to leave the bear pen. And
but, mate, he's also played rugby as well. I think there's about five of them. He's cloned.
What would be the influence for him to travel out to the Cowboys, Mick?
I think Luke Taylor.
Yep.
I think Luke and Ferg, well, obviously Luke, got in his ear and convinced him to come out, looking at what they're trying to do for the competition. You know, as everybody knows, Dungowan last year were the wooden spooners, so they had to probably to go out and get a couple, and he was obviously on the hit list. But they've done fantastically well to go. I think they won one game and had a draw last year to go there to hosting a grand final is a fantastic effort.
Tell me this, boys, the influx of the players such as Tevita that have come into the Group 4 comp in all grades and with all clubs, we're only judging them basically on what they're doing on the field. But some of these guys have actually been there, done that at a higher level before they've actually come out of the bush and played some footy. There's a couple of unknowns amongst them. Kick has been unsuccessful. So Dungown remained 4 points to nil.
Conversion unsuccessful. Score remains Dungown 4, North Tamworth nil.
All right, Craig.
Dungown. Like to congratulate their Ladies League Tag side, who actually come from fourth position to win the competition, and that's a big effort in itself. So congratulations to the Dungown club, who had three teams playing today, and one's already taken home a trophy. And
good to see. Craig and Mick, tell me this. North were only a matter of moments into the game. They're down 4-0. We talked about experience before. If you're Blanchy, what are you talking to your players? What are you saying?
Mate, it's very early on in the game. You wouldn't be saying too much. It's a lucky try, a bit of weak defence down that right-hand side. He won't be saying too much at this point, mate.
There were a couple of games earlier the year against Narrabri and both Katinga where I think they were down by 12 points and come back with good results. And I find it interesting that Brett Jarrett's actually starting from the bench today. Brett's a quality footballer, starting from the bench. Obviously, they've got a bit of a game plan with that.
Maybe working on fatigue later in the game, but it's Dungown in possession as they kick down from the halfway line back towards the North's line now. Ball's been retrieved. Nice solid tackle from the 13. It's Kobe Bone. Taking forward, and that was Cody Byrne that with a solid hit. That's 17 metres out.
Blanche pops out, makes a nice little break. Gets away to his winger, number 5, in Damien Scott, down the left-hand side, gets tackled, 40 metres out.
Rolling forward. Again, once North get possession, they get a roll like this. Some good structures. Smoodle again, gets the ball out wide. Yorkie said thank you very much.
Just a little bit on Damien Scott last weekend. In the preliminary final, he played two full games. He played on the wing for reserve grade and then a late pullout because of injury. He had to go and start in first grade.
Is that right?
Yeah, so he earned himself a spot this week with his efforts from last week. So well done.
This thing has been a long season, Craig. Again, the last game I saw Jeremy York play, he was at North, but trained by a bad hamstring. So good to see he's actually overcome that to take the field in the grand final.
Yeah, he's a solid little nugget. Wouldn't be hard to do it. A hamstring, would it?
He's a Hulk. Wouldn't be very long, would it? Dungown in possession. Fergs directing play from dummy half. And referee keeping a good 10, Luke Sheeter.
Bear.
Just a little bit of useless trivia too for the people out there that want to know. All the referees today is their first grand final appearances in all grades. So well done to the referees that were selected to do those jobs.
Good hit up by Bear there, Bear Aldwood, Jason Aldwood. It was a great story in the Leader this week about Bear and his journey to the Dungown Cowboys. Obviously, originally a player with Sean Ferguson and Tubbs, those guys at Farrer, and has been a bit of a journeyman around the country and now back at Dungown playing a bit of bush footy.
We talked earlier about the rebuild of the Dungown club. Craig and Mick, it's been basically built around people. And those two, realistically, apart from the hierarchy on the board,
in the region, they've probably got the biggest football base when you're counting juniors and their senior grades. They've probably got the biggest base of players in the region, which is a fantastic effort for such a small community.
Okay, Ferg's got the ball going forward. Okay, a matter of 3 or 4 metres out now. What can the Cowboys do?
It's on the last, mate. They've got to get a kick away here. Dribble
good
it in.
Good recovery. Got their runners off.
Good work
offside
there. Young Ashton Constable took the ball. It Dungowan being caught inside the 10, so North will get to take a tap from the 30-metre mark and play down the field.
Mattis going forward. Good tackle.
I didn't think Josh Schmoodle would take a hit up. He's just passed it to the fullback.
Here, you take it. I'll do it later. He plays very much like his dad.
He's been good this year. He's come from reserve grade. Jake Vost. Geez, he's been strong. I've been impressed by young Jakey this year, Mick.
Yeah, I think he's exactly right, but I think he's more suited to the middle than he is an edge. And you'll probably notice he's still got the 12 on, but him and Kobe Bone have traded positions. Kobe's playing on that left edge and Jake back in the middle. And I think that suits Jake's game better, and it probably suits Kobe Bone's.
Been
a little bit lighter and a little bit more fleet-footed.
They're struggling out of their half at the moment. They've just taken two runs that they've...
McManus again.
Hasn't been good, but there's a nice run by Jake McManus. Nice hit
Smeedle
up.
Smeedle through the middle.
Smeedle through the middle. Makes a nice break. Goes around the fullback. And he's going to score. Josh Smeedle from 40 out absolutely brains them. Yeah. Brings back some memories from his old man.
Let's just take a deep breath. That came from absolutely nothing.
Josh is an old man.
Score by number 11, Josh Smeedle.
Well known.
Take the score to Dungowan 4, Northampton 4.
Josh is known for those tight runs in behind the A's and the markers, and you'll see him do that another 20 times today. He may not make those breaks again, but he'll certainly get them going forward and on that front foot because of the quick play of the ball.
But again, you know he's going to do that, Craig.
Look, it's too that looks a little bit too easy, but what you got to understand with players like Josh, and I strongly believe his dad was very much the same, but. Yeah, you know, they've got a special amount of time in behind those A's, and they do like to pop out. And it's the type of player they are that people just slip off them. So, mate, what a great run. Straight up the middle, straight behind the A and B defenders.
The opening try for both sides, I don't want to be a bit of a party pooper, but you probably think that both tries for the two teams were probably a little bit soft in your thinking there. Like Josh straight through the middle and... Tex, did it pretty easy down this left edge for Dungowan.
He did.
Northampton's right edge. Yeah. So both sides probably need to tighten up defensively a little bit.
Conversion is successful. Again, just recapping on that, the
conversion
try.
Conversion for Northampton advance successful by number 7, Mick Sheridan. Taking the score to Dungowan 4, Northampton advance 6.
The fact that Josh has been hovering around that centre of the ruck. Again, we said just a very quick tip on before, Craig.
Yep.
But again, they're taking that opportunity now. Very smart play and choosing. From a Dungowan point of view, they're now probably going to have their eye on Josh to see if he's going to do that again. Again, he's got them thinking, taking his mind away from other players.
The thing is, you're 15 minutes into the game, so, at this level, this is when they're starting to get a little bit tired, especially in a grand final. You come out pretty hard and energised in that first 10 minutes, and then 15 in, you're going to see a few opportunities pop up here, I think.
North Tamworth running the ball out to short of their 20.
There's a player for me to watch is Europe, Jaffa Williams, the fullback.
We've christened him Jaffa.
He's exceptionally strong up top. The amount of times that he will break tackles one-on-one or out of nowhere makes a break is quite phenomenal. And it's hard to defend against. He's a good returner of the ball, but just his strength, upper body strength.
Yeah, it's great to see Europe. In the comp, mate. I know a fair bit of Yerubi, and I watched him as a schoolboy down in Sydney. He actually went to St Joseph's College and was a representative Australian schoolboy rugby union player. So it's great to see him move his way to Tamworth and find a home at North. And yeah, I've watched him this year. He's been really strong.
His transition from rugby union to rugby league's been very, very easy for him. I know rugby union backs tend to find it a little bit easier than rugby union forwards and vice versa. The league forwards going to rugby find it a bit harder than the backs. But he's certainly a player to keep an eye on.
All right, let's see what Dungowan can do. The Cowboys have got the ball. We're just on the halfway line. It's coming up towards. We're in possession on the second tackle now.
Zach Parker takes a strong hit up. He's taken a fair few hit ups early in the game. Another good one from Bear. Bear Allwood.
Solid. Bear again, Bear. Going down the blind again. Spreading the ball out. Good defence from the Bears.
Brandon Parry takes a nice little hit up there. He was very strong in the final against...
Going the kick through.
Major Semi.
Ball still alive. And guess what? Nearly. There was an opportunity. There just was an opportunity.
He looks to be limping. Trent Taylor looks to be limping pretty bad there. He's carrying
Well, apparently hurt himself at training on Thursday night. So I heard through the bubbler talk this morning. But yeah,
he doesn't look good at all out there, Mick.
Just, I know I give you as a player from North Timoth to keep an eye on, but for me, Cody Byrne for Dungown.
The winning double for today is home side 3, away 11. That's home side 3, away side 11. If you have the winning double, please present it to the staff at the bar to collect your prize.
He probably weighs about 70 kilo, fully dressed. But you won't find too many players in the comp with the timing that he has defensively with the shots. And he got one a little bit earlier, but you'll find it today that he will shorten somebody up if they're running fairly straight. His tackle technique's very, very good. So he's a player to watch from the Dungowan side.
Cody Byrne v. Kobe Bone, mate. Very similar type players.
Cody and Kobe.
Ashton Constable. So we've got Brock Morgan bringing the ball out. Just looking at the strapping on Trent Taylor, which is
the
fullback for Dave. Thigh could be a hammy.
Yeah.
Either way, not a good move. Sean Ferguson taking the ball forward.
Trent's very nice. Tough. He'll find a way to make the game. I've seen him playing a divisional game early in the year where he probably had no right to be on the paddock, but he did because he's just a tough kid.
Again. Nice ball by Cody Byrne. Popped one, second phase.
20 metres out, Dungown on the attack. Swinging out wide. Down towards the corner. The ball beats them. We'll come back to the 20. Couple of changes now for Dungown.
Yeah, it's,
here goes Matty.
Brady Jarrett.
Matty
Jarrett. Matty, you'd love to meet me.
Yeah, I bet you would be. Goes on there, Matty. I'm sure Matty would be listening somewhere. Yeah.
Matty be watching Jarrett? Live stream somewhere.
You won't be. You can't miss Brett. He's the big number 8 with the skull cap on. Norths on the attack. Mick, what's the story on the number 6 for North in Ethan Collins?
Again, how Tex come from North to Dungown, Ethan come from Dungown to North this year. I believe that he knows some of the Northies boys. Just wanted a change of scenery, and I think he wanted probably to cement down, to cement down that pivot
number
spot.
Well, he's had a good year.
I think he played a lot of centre out here last year, and I think he wanted to play 5-8, and North give him that opportunity, and he's had a good year.
Yeah. There's Brett Jarrett's first run.
Yeah, it's a nice run up the middle. Quick play of the ball.
Cody again.
Gets it to young Burnsy.
Tell you what, if he had 6 or 7 kilo on him. And we go ball back inside. It's Tavita again.
Tavita again, a strong run, breaks tackle, breaks outside.
Need of a good hairdresser.
And they've just dropped the ball.
Going frustrating.
Coach killer.
30 metres out. Cowboys were in possession.
Look, you need to hold the ball in those positions, mate. You've just got the ball back. You're on the 30 attacking. You know, first play of the ball, you drop it.
I'm not sure if the people at home can see the flags flying on the top of the goalpost, but it's a very, very big wind. It's been here all day. What kind of lead do you reckon you need, Craig, at half time with that kind of wind?
Look, I'm expecting, if when they have to, Ferg will try and take full advantage out of that win, but they've only got another 20 minutes, to use it. So, mate, it's blown 25, 30 knots. I'd want, it's 12 points.
Okay, now, the other games that have been played today, the game that's run home, run into the win the second half of one.
Which is strange, yes.
Yeah, both
so
teams.
I set you up there,
both,
didn't I?
No, you didn't, because both teams didn't know how to use the wind. Moree put it out on two occasions on the full. They were trying to, they just didn't maybe have the ability to use their kicking game to their strength. Very two different exactly players here, you know, Ferguson, Blanche, they'll know what it means.
North Tamworth on the attack.
Scotty Blanche makes a nice little break, puts it on the toe, and they're going to tackle Trent Taylor in the 10 metres. They're going to have to work it out from here.
19 minutes remaining. It's 6 points to four. And
good tackle. Nice shot.
North Tamworth leading at the moment. This is the first grade grand final in the 2022 Group 4 Rugby League. The Dungowan Cowboys, the North Tamworth Bears.
Ready, Jarrett with another nice hit up.
Again, both of you guys having been kickers in your playing days, if the wind's against you, it's just a matter of keep the ball low, isn't it?
Pretty simple. And this is a good smart move from Trenny. I think he's just hoiked that down. He probably wanted to connect a bit better. Oh, no, it's got the good roll. And a good straight Europe's line there it. From Dungowan. So there's not many back there to help out, old Europe.
They're going to have to get back really quick. There's a few back now.
North Tamworth are making a dual change here. Looks like Ben Jarvis is coming off. I'm not sure.
Yorkie's made a really good run there. He's got his side a good 20 metres first run out. Europe's there to take the second one up.
James Cooper going on now for the first time.
Got him offside.
And we've also got Tevita on the sideline ready to come off. So changes up front for the North Tamworth Bears. Jake McManus going off now. Tevita just about to take his place. Realistically, they lose nothing with that change, do they? Both got bowl. Both got some skills and some size. North Tamworth on the attack. Coming down the blind.
Nice little short ball. Little short ball from Mitchell Sheridan. Dude, he's been good this season. Shero, Mick, you know, watched him last week. He was just great. You know, he looks like he's not doing much, but he just shows up every play.
What I like James about Cooper. Mitch Sheridan, he's a footballer. The number on his back doesn't make a difference. He just plays footy and might have a try here.
Nice quick ball. Referee Luke Sheeder, held up.
We've got it held up, but that was the fifth and last. So something a bit different there from the North Tamworth Bears running it on the last. Nearly got fruits from it. But yeah, just back on Mitchie Sheridan. Again, he was part of the our academy stuff in his younger years and then played divisional stuff last year. But, you know, he's a bloke you can throw anywhere on the field. You know what you're going to get from him. He's one of those blokes you love to have as a coach because he doesn't care what number's on his back. He just plays footy and he plays what he sees.
Speaking of coaches, tell me this, boys. We've had virtually a transition from the Bears coaching. Paul Boyce in charge this year. Again, the culture within the club, we've had the big fella there for quite a while now and some of their senior players. Boyce fitting into the squad and bringing him to a grand final. A big effort?
Yeah, look, he's done really, really good. It was always going to be a hard job to take on a North Tamworth side.
It was a tough start of the year, wasn't it?
But I think with the experience that he's got around him, you've got James Cooper and Josh, obviously. Shero's what you call experience. Jakey McManus, Scotty Blanche. You know, there's plenty of experience there to help him in that transition in the first grade. And I guess some people may not know that North Tamworth's actually gone for seven titles in a row because the last 2 years we haven't made a grand final.
We haven't had a grand final.
Narrabri, to their credit, were minor premiers last year before the competition got halted. But North's won six in a row before COVID.
Bang. Kicked through offside. From Dungowan. Paddy Burns called offside.
Okay.
In front of the kicker.
Ryan Ingram's gone on from Shawnee Ferguson. He's another young fella that's quite clever with the ball. He'll engage the markers.
Group 4 major sponsors for the day. Tui's, West Entertainment, Winanali and Ken O'Tire.
He'll engage the markers and the A defenders. Very skillful with the ball in hand, young Ryan, and holds his own defensively.
Isn't it a trend we've seen even in the NRL these days that players, you know, teams playing two hookers, you know?
Yeah, I'm not sure where or why or how it come in, but it's a lot of the, even, you know, like you said, NRL bush clubs, they all seem to carry a number nine. Me personally, I like to carry a bloke that can play nine, but not necessarily a specific
nine.
That's
only because you never wanted to go off, mate.
I was just going to say that. Yeah.
But I used to put my hand up plenty.
Yeah. Out on the wing. No, but Ringers, as you
Jeremy
say.
Jeremy York taking the ball clear now.
Oh, great
Ashton
tackle.
Constable. But a good
tackle
good down there.
You did good to stay in there, Ashton.
Great tackle, Josh McCall.
But ball coming out wide now for the Bears. Blanchy, it's the ball back inside James Cooper.
Nice hotline there by James Cooper. Blanche, Scotty Blanche, holds the ball, two hands, all the way to the line. Great try.
It's a lot of good lead-up right there, and I want to make mention to Ashton Constable. It was good hands by, good pass from Jeremy York. He's not known for his passing game, Yorkie, but he did. But for Ashton to actually stay in field there was exceptional.
Absolutely. That inside line, I thought, from James Cooper too, sort of surprised me. I don't see James change direction very often, but he got on the inside.
Well, mate, if there's somebody that can tackle and hit hard in front of you, he'll change pretty quick.
is it true? Look, I've noticed that he's now a fashion guru as well, but again, has he been a Jenny Craig? What's the go? He's slimmed down like you wouldn't. Married life.
Yeah, well, I think it wasn't married long life? Ago that he did a ridiculous amount of walking for a charity. Where I think he got his fitness bug back. But
well, I'll tell you what, it's worked.
It might have been part of his prerequisite to work at West Entertainment Group that he can't be so many kilos. So
yeah, it could be.
Now that he's the CEO in there, he probably had to look a little bit.
Well, he's looking good, playing good footy as well. And a happily married man. Good on your Coops.
And just before thanks to our major sponsors.
Yes, and West I thought before anybody gets carried away, we're all good friends with James. He'll see it as a banter.
Good on you, Coops. That was a great ball inside. And as I said, Scotty Blanche, mate, holds the ball in two hands, slices through them and scores a try.
I noticed one thing at this early stage of the game, and we've got 12 minutes remaining in the first half. Crowd's been very quiet.
You can't hear it for the wind.
For the making a hell of a ruckus in Dungown.
Well, I think because a lot of the footy hasn't been played in either 20.
The three earlier games, crowds were really involved.
Well, I think this game here, there hasn't been
mate,
a lot of
seriously,
football.
How long have you been doing this?
In a 20-metre zone.
The microphone you're talking to, seriously?
You
have to talk to your manager. We're paying you the big bucks. We expect you to do the job, Craig. Seriously?
Yeah, sorry. Sorry, Ray.
By the way, that's Mick Smurtle. Craig Powers here, Ray McCoy. Craig and I, the pros, and we're carrying Mick.
And there's 12 minutes to go in the second half,
on,
ladies
here we
and
go.
Gentlemen.
Do the sledge.
Matt Parsons was meant to be here today, but he knew that he had to work with McCoy, so he said no.
Score remaining, Dungown Cowboys 4, North Melbourne Bears 10.
Okay, 10-4
I thought you were going to talk about the other sledge that I give you once before.
10-4, big buddy.
No, we'll leave that alone, Mick. All right. Okay,
right,
very
let's
strong.
See what Trent can do with his kick. It was good to see him put a high bomb up. That's the first bomb I've seen all day in this win, Michael.
Yeah. It's actually had a quiet game, Craig.
No, there wasn't one high ball put up in that last game. Well, and with this wind.
Nice deep kick. Got it on the full. The North about to bring it out. Cooper again. Not a hair out of place. Second tackle for the Bears. Actually, referee Sheather keeping a good 10. Allowing the game to flow. Cooper very much involved.
He's had two hit-ups in this set, Coops. A nice hit-up in the end by Bones to finish the set and a good kick.
Brock Morgan bringing the ball back up. On their 40, that's Tevita. Hallward again. Made some strong runs.
Nice.
Ball down the wing again. Strong run from Brock Morgan. Tevita in the dummy half position. What can he do from here? Very strong indeed. Away he goes, heading towards the centre. And what do the Cowboys do from here? Great opportunity. Spreading it wide. Trent again, Trent Taylor.
Good play from the winger there.
Waiting for Ethan Anzarkle to inject himself into the game. He's had a relatively quiet start. I think at some stage you'll see him start running the ball a little bit more. He's very good on his feet, Ethan, and I'm surprised he hasn't had a crack at him yet, but it'll come. And
what's his story, Michael? Where's he from, Ethan?
He went to Farrow. He was in our academy last year. A good young kid, obviously a pivot.
Just out of juniors?
He did a little bit of refereeing a couple of years ago. He was sort of tossing and turning which way he wanted to go, a player Smoodle or a ref. And then obviously come back to being a player. And he's had a really, really good year.
I hate to say, but just then the Bears looked a little bit disjointed. They've got the kick away. Trent Taylor with the ball, bringing it back, heading towards the halfway line. Good crowd on hand out at Dungown for the Group 4 first grade grand final.
Yeah, I think I was a bit disappointed with the crowds at North last week. So, fingers crossed that we got a good crowd today for the grand final, and it's actually turned out. It's really good.
Josh Norwood again, consistent now, some good runs.
Great run there.
Keep going back in behind the ruck, Craig. Down the blind again. They've done this consistently.
Someone's got to take that.
Ashton Constable, and I think we've had a turnover.
I don't think he gets it down.
Well, the linesman's actually in the end goal. Ryan Smeedle's
just a little bit of communication at the back there with Europe and Ashton. It was covered fairly well, but they
either
didn't.
That or urgency, Mick. It didn't look like a lot of urgency from either player to really.
I think they're looking at each other to take it. Somebody just needed to put their hand up and say it's my ball and basically gifted Dungowan a try.
Dungowan scored by number 11, Josh McLaughlin. Dungowan 8, North Tamworth 10.
So with 8 minutes to go, we've got a game on our hands, 10 points to 8. North Tamworth leading Dungowan Cowboys. We've got a kick to come. And again, Craig, you being the better goal kicker between you and Mick Smoodle, you'd be aiming, a fair way to the right of the post.
Look, I'd have my boots off and socks off at the moment. I used to kick barefoot back in the day.
Did you?
Toe poking.
I'll be back in Trento in from this one. He only just missed the last one, and I think he'll make that slight adjustment. And although the wind's picked up.
There's a massive right to left wind. I don't know if the viewers can see it. As I say, 25, 30 foot knot wind blowing a gale down here.
You'd hate to be on the water. Left.
And as Mick, said before, it's a 10 to, we believe it's probably a 10 to 12 point wind. So.
Oh, a little bit stronger than he thought, so he's missed it.
Right to left, and he's missed the goal.
So North Tamworth.
Conversion unsuccessful.
10 points to
8.
Now, if you can see on the cameras now, we've got Trent Taylor going back to his position after the kick, and he's definitely holding that injury up.
I'd hate to have a horse's lame, as it put it that way, Ray.
Well, your money's not on it. But again, that's you've got a full off season to actually recover, so you give it what you can.
How good does the crowd look down at the bar end of the oval?
Yeah, no, always well supported, out here at Dungowan. I've been privy to a couple of grand finals back out here in the second division days, and always well supported. The local community made it great in these country areas.
I'll tell you what,
great to see Blommy here today.
Yeah, and just on Peter Blom today, they named the scoreboard in his honour. So it's the Peter Blom scoreboard. So. Just with the tireless work that he's done for the Dungowan football community, and I think it's a great honour for him and great recognition of the Dungowan club.
For a man who's not even involved with Group 4 Rugby League for 100 years, but for a man that's retired a couple of years ago, he's still pretty much involved.
Great tackle there, Jakey Vost.
Well done, Blobby. I'll tell you where you don't want to see Blommy.
The Blom ball.
At a funeral. I'll tell you what, you can have that job, Blommy. Okay, Dungowan Cowboys bringing the ball out. Just over 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Sean Ferguson gets the ball away. It's a floater, as they say.
Taken well, solid defence on the 40-metre line.
North boys a little bit slow coming back.
Yeah, starting to feel the pinch with 4 minutes to go in the game in this first half.
Cooper again. cameras could probably pick up the grandstand across the
Jake
other,
Bennett,
other side
solid
of the field.
Run.
That's the goal passes over there, Craig.
He's been another strong rookie this year, young Jake Bennett, Mick.
Yeah, he played a lot of reserve grade last year. He's most people will probably recognise him wearing headgear this year. He's decided to get rid of it, but you know, he's another good, young, strong kid that North have brought through over the last couple of years.
Sherrod puts it high. No one wants to take that one. And a bit of speed through the middle by Brennan Parry.
Yeah. He's had a solid year too, Craig.
Absolutely, yeah. Mate. He had a cracker in the major semi.
Got a good set of feet on a young Brando. It's
oh, had a look.
It's probably not the kind of ball that your halfback wants to be receiving.
Matty Wilson looked up and went, what the? Okay, smack bang on halfway.
Maybe his shorts got caught on his knees. He's got a big set of shorts.
3 minutes, Maddie. 33 remaining. Mitch Sheridan to feed the ball.
Good on you, Wilso. Big yell out to Wilso, mate. Good player.
Good club man, too.
Led Dungown very well this year.
European again.
He's been at the club for 4 or 5 years. I think maybe a bit longer, actually. Again, for him, this would be a great moment for him making the grand final with what they went through with second division and initially coming up when they were promoted a few years ago. So it's a good result for Shero. Sorry for Matt.
Back inside for Smoodle. It's been very quiet the last 10 minutes, Josh Smoodle, the big number 11 for the Bears.
He's just sucking them in.
He'll probably come good now.
Oh, that's a great run.
Ethan Collins.
Great run, Ethan Collins, through a little dummy inside.
All right, where's Smoodle?
Kobe Bone pushes hard towards the line. Another strong run.
Held
he's
up
been
again.
Held up. Jeez, he does that a lot, doesn't he? Gets to that line and pushes through.
This is the coach killer, isn't it? 3 minutes to go, either side of halfway, do you or don't you? Don't let dribble points dribble in. If you can, it's your chance to actually add points. Coming out wide, Smoodle. Got that sidestep again. Blanch back outside to Vuda.
Europe.
Yep, he's got it.
Right, left.
There he goes. Lost the ball. Last chance now, Cowboys. Last chance before half time for the Cowboys to get back up here, Craig. Back we're in the last.
Yeah, it was a little bit sloppy. A little bit sloppy there, left, right. Bring it back to Europe and he drops the ball on the tackle.
Oh. Well,
I've seen them ones called forward before, but anyway, they got away with it, Jarrett.
Ringers
gets it to Wilso. Wilso trips over his shorts again.
Oh, touch forward. No, they've let it go. 40 metres out.
And here he is, Ferguson. The old maestro, mate. Ferguson up the middle.
He's got a pull.
He'll pop it to the left. Gets it to DeVita. He's tackled well down in the right-hand side by Europe.
Last tackle. I tell you what, he's strong. Back to Sean again. Going out wide. What can they do? Trent Taylor. He's kicked for his winger. He's got it. Massive.
Great.
Absolutely
kick.
Massive.
Great take. Great vision. Trent Taylor.
Incredible. Liam Mack on the end of that. And again, we've got, basically 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Once again, though, you know, I've got to bring it back to the old maestro down the left-hand side. Sean Ferguson makes a break down the left, catches them with their pants down. They spread it back to the right. Trent Taylor, absolutely great vision for a young bloke. Puts a nice kick in for his winger. Catches on the full. What a try.
Again, I think the fact Ferg had the ball over this side, Craig, he's dragged everyone's attention over this side. And again, going back to Trent Taylor, the fact that 90% of players would have run that ball. He's looked out, found his winger, not alone, but certainly with the pace out there in Liam Mack. He's put the ball perfectly positioned, and again for Liam Mack to catch the ball on the full, go over, not only go over, but come back towards the centre of the field. And again,
Control the kick with that win was a big effort in itself.
Well, that gives the Cowboys the lead going into halftime now, 12-10. We've got a kick to come. 12 points to 10. Cowboys leading North Tamworth. This is a grand final we wanted, we expected. And again, with the big game from North Tamworth last week against Moree, Mick, again, they've turned around and it's a competitive grand final. But all credit to Dungown. At the moment, going into a half-time break at this stage, 12 points to 10. Will they get the kick?
I think it'll make the kick. It'll make it 14 points to 10. And that's one thing you don't want, that try right before half-time. It's usually a good indicator who's going to go through in the second half. But as we said, that wind is strong.
Half-time score in the 2022 Group 4 First Grade Grand Final. Dungown Cowboys 14, North Tamworth Bears 10.
All right, let's just wrap this up before we go. Craig, if you will, just a quick wrap on that first half. Scoreline of Mick, you can do it the same as well. 14 points to 10 that the Cowboys in front. Second half.
Look, as I said, you know, you don't want that try scored right before, you know, before half-time. But Dungown done a great job, great kick to score that try. It's still a tight game. I think North have had the upper hand most of the game, and Dungown seemed to have scored a couple of soft tries. But, you know, I really think it's pretty even at the moment. And
we'll go from there. All right, we'll let the ground announcer do his job. We'll take a bit of a quick break and we'll come back for the second half. You're watching the 2022 Group 4 Rugby League Grand Final from Dungown. At the moment, we go to halftime. Dungown 14, lead the North Tamworth Bears 10.
Lehman CrossFit and C&D Murphy Hay Sales. We'll be right back.
at the door they found. The head nurse spoke up to leave this one alone. She could tell by the way that I was bad to the bone.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've just drawn the raffle for the lotto ticket board that was being being passed around. We have a red ticket, F71. That is red ticket, F71. If you have that ticket, you're the lucky winner of the lotto scratchy board. Another reminder for also for the meat tray. Whoever belongs to that meat tray had the winning ticket, green, I think, F49. Just a reminder, collect your meat tray down at the bar area. At the conclusion of the first grade games today, we have an under 16 game being the Tigers Challenge. It'll be Moree versus Katingle. So there is one more game, an under 16 Tigers Challenge at the conclusion of the first grade game. We have all kids off the field now. Get ready to take the field for the second half. Off the field, please.
All kids off the field, please. All right, as the players take their positions back on the field again, welcome back, Ray, and we've got a special guest here.
It's that announcement you need. All kids off the field. We're about to go into the second half of the 2022 Group 4 Rugby League Grand Final. Dungowan 14, leading North Tamworth Bears 10. And a very good afternoon to Kevin Anderson. G'day, champion.
G'day, Ray. G'day, Craig.
Hey, Kevy.
Righto, mate, what's the go? Which team are you playing for, or who are you backing?
Yeah. Look, I just think Group 4 Rugby League Country, Rugby League generally, like it's a great day out here. It's blowing a gale, but great crowds, a big gate. It's just good to see bush footy alive and well, mate.
Well, again, we've been around for a couple of years, and the Mick Smoodle's here as well. Again, it's we've said that earlier today. This is really just going back to the roots, the grassroots, as to being, you know, bush footy at its best. We've had four quality games. This one's certainly leading up to what we expected, a scoreline of 14-10. But your involvement with rugby league, did you ever have a dig when you were a kid, apart from tackling me?
No, I used to hang around Tamworth City for a little while in the mid-90s. I was running oranges and a bit of water back then. Oh. But look, it's just great to see it alive and well. A lot of cars around the ground here, and the rec ground here at Dungowan doesn't get any better than this.
All good. I see Kevin Tongue's here as well, but Barnaby's here as well. Yeah, I didn't see what Guernsey had on.
Yeah, I don't know. The big man's up in the seats up there. He looks like he's having a great day.
He is. All right, Craig, we're back into the second half. Congratulations for everything you're doing for the bush, mate. By the way, I won't plan too much, but some grandstand covers for the Gunnedah Kitchener Park. Can we work on that one next? It's all good.
Well, look at the lights here. It's just fantastic. But I'll let you boys get on with it. It's great to be here. Thanks,
guys. Good to see you here, Kev. Thank you very much indeed. Mick Smoodle's back in the chair as well. And Mick's quit. He's out of shocker.
Thanks, Kerry. Yeah, no, the bad mistake there by Josh Smeedle. His turnover goes straight to Dungowan on the 50-metre line, mate. Bert Jarrod, another strong run. DeVita, strong tackle.
Another penalty.
Oh, got one in the ribs from Andrew Thomas, the Tominator.
One of his
Dungowan
best.
Cowboy player.
Good to see a bit of sledging back in here as well. Okay, we're in the second half. As we mentioned earlier, thank you to Kevin Anderson, but the scoreline 14-10 and the Dungowan Cowboys leading the North Tamworth Bears.
Who's been your standout so far, Kevy?
Yeah, look, I think if you look at Josh Schmiedel, he's just a beast when he picks up the ball and starts powering. I do like the fact that James Cooper, when he came on for North Tamworth, short and popped that ball under pressure that gave them a really good try just to the right-hand side of the field. So, look, Tuivasa Pelisi for... How do you like that?
Call the police.
100%. Yeah, 100% for Dungown has also been playing well.
Strong run now.
He's had a couple of nice runs, Tex, mate, out the back there. And Dungown's just lost the ball. What a shame. Good lead up to that.
What about from the Dungown point of view, Kevin? Look, I think you're only watching one team.
No, we're watching both teams here. I think it's pretty even spread at the moment when you look at the scoreline of 14-10. This breeze, I think, as both sides get tired in the second half, this breeze, the smarter ball players will be able to make this breeze work to their advantage. And I don't think reserve grade played the wind the way they should have, but I think the tighter these teams go on in the second half, the wind can be to their advantage.
Oh, was that a knock-on? Yes, it was.
Oh, no, he's actually held up. We thought there was a little fumble there from Mitch Sheridan, but
the referee's
corrected us.
Craig, tell me this. The players that stood out in the first half, to me, I'm with you, James Cooper, had a cracker, but also Jason Allwood. When Jason went on, he's made a couple of big bursts and held them up.
Yeah, he was strong early in the early part of that half until he went off. Bear was really strong. And a penalty offside. North to get the kick.
We're on the 30. North's in possession. Again, Sean Ferguson back on the
paddock. Scotty Blanch will take a little short kick.
I'll tell you what, that breeze is a shocker. Even with that low kick then, playing havoc with it.
Jakey Bennett will punch one up through the middle.
Smack bang on halfway. Blanchard,
James Cooper ready to run one unhit, one up from the back fence. Here he goes. Mitchy Sheridan inside back ball. Inside to Europe. Europe's through. Gets rid of one, gets rid of two. He's strong and he is quick. Straight through him. Great try. Europe, Jaffa Williams, ladies and gents.
That's amazing. Again, the two tries that stand out for North Tamworth.
Nelson Joseph, Joey Schoolboy, Kevy.
Nice.
You're from there too?
No.
Really? Mick, what's...
North Tamworth scored by number one, Europe, Jaffa Williams.
On your Jaffa.
Taking the score to 14-all with a kick to come.
Both tries from North now. The one from Joshy Smoodle plus that one, again, through the middle. They won't say a soft underbelly, but Streeth got one, and then that was just pure pace. Straight through. Well, Mick, what school did you go to, mate? These guys are going to colleges and the like. Where'd you go?
Oberon High. Why is that important?
Oh, no, the boys at Skye about where they went to school. I've gone to Gunnedah High. The best 3 years of my life was year 10. Couldn't get out of it. There we go. Oberon High, mate.
I went to Tamworth High, mate, the nursery.
You were there?
Yeah, I was at the nursery.
Good on you, mate.
Where all the good footy players went.
So I got the year
anyway, I got a few shout-outs here, guys. Shout-out to... Jamie Walden, he's listening to the footy in Pokes Men Cave. G'day out there, Pokey, a great old rugby league player for the Benamere Mountain Men. I've also got Sammy Wentworth. Young Sammy Wentworth set up the Cowboys. Young Sammy's an ex-Cowboy player now with the Canberra Raiders.
Good as gold. And again, this is a big shout-out to Folmac TV Productions, who are bringing you all the coverage, do it on a regular basis, bringing the sport out to you, so it doesn't matter where you are. I wonder where the furthest person is that's watching the game today. There's probably expats, Craig, overseas, picked it up and watching, whether it be old Cowboys or Bears, whatever the case may be.
We've also got Jackson Wilden listening up in the snowy mountains of Benamere. Civil... sponsor for North's and been a great supporter of rugby league in the area in the last couple of years.
Successful was the kick.
16-14.
I can tell you there's a lovely young lady watching the game down in Melbourne with a group of people, so we're attracting all the masses, Craig. This could be the start of something big. Mick, don't say a word.
I find it interesting that you found that there was a lady listening, Ray.
They just happened
rather
to,
than just say a person.
They just happened to let me know, mate. Just happened to let me know. Trust me.
Okay. Another strong run from Tavita off the kickoff.
Okay, it's game on.
Josh Schmiedel up the middle, takes another, take the first hit up and loses the ball into Matty, actually Brady Jarrett.
16-14, 33 minutes remaining. Again, opportunity now for the Dungowan Cowboys.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shame, I think. You just want to bust a couple out there. It was such a strong wind, really. You know, I'd be just aiming at taking two strong hit-ups and hooking it down the other end. There's a really good chance. I'm just so surprised no one's gone for a 40-20 yet.
Shawnee Ferguson playing halfback in that scrum. Cowboys in possession. And gave it to the biggest player on the field to run forward.
The whip it.
Paddy Lang.
And Sean Ferguson takes another hit up the middle. Is he a ball player? Is he a front row? What is he, this bloke? Footballer. He's just a great footballer.
Yeah, running across field, Allwood.
Brady Jarrett flicks one. Brandon Parry steps left and hurled up just short of the line.
They've stayed in possession, which is good. Will they spread the ball? Players are wide.
Gets it to Ringers. Ringers to Ferguson.
Wide again.
Ferguson to the whippet.
Kick through.
Trent with a little one on the toe.
And
we've got Dungowan offside.
I'd assume Tavita was probably being ruled as offside then. He's very quick to get up there.
Just for the people that like their stats out there, that's the third penalty Dungowan's given away for offside on the kick. Just it's the little things that turn games, and now North Tamworth are going to kick themselves out of trouble. And it's just, as a coach, that's what you call a coach killer. That's three times now on a kick chase they've been done for offside.
Comments from the super coach.
Big Tavita going through.
Yorkie's taken high. Ref misses it. Be another hit up by Jakey Bennett.
Ball back inside.
Back inside to Shero.
We're just on halfway now.
Blanche breaks away again. It's nice little Beedle. Short kick.
Yeah, there could be a penalty
what
for
will
this.
The chase there, was. Be?
There could be a penalty. I'm just watching referee Sheether, but no, there's not.
No, it's
Josh
Smoodle.
Josh Smoodle was on his way to come through, and from where I can see from our commentary position, that he was blocked to run through. But again, no penalty there. Play on. Cowboys bring it out.
Another shout out to Azza Sampson, next player, X-Group 4 player. G'day Az out there in Port Macquarie watching the game. Thanks, mate.
Step back inside. Gets the ball away.
Trent Taylor gets one, hooks one left and out over the sideline. They're going to struggle against that wind all half kicking.
I think we've also got some grand finals happening today out in Western Division. The Panthers playing out that way with Hayden Smith and DJ Smith playing, ex-Gunnedah Bulldogs, having another shot at a title. Bears on the attack. The big fella takes it through with Benny Jarvis. We're on the 30.
Another strong run. Jake Bennett. Kobe Bone takes one. Beats one tackle.
16-14. North Tamworth leading. 10 metres out.
Little kick inside. It should sit up well. Nice little kick there by Scotty Blanch.
Well heard. We're heading out to the 20. We have an injury in the in goal.
I actually thought Trent knocked that one out.
Yeah.
Okay.
The trainer's now gone out to Trent Taylor.
Yep. Trent Taylor's down behind the line in the in goal, mate. I think he's clutching at that. That left hamstring, it'd be a big loss if they were to lose Trent at this stage in the game. Very, very important time in the game. I'm also working out of their 30 with another hit up from Captain Coach Sean Ferguson, the old maestro.
Orwood again, another strong run.
No, that's Brady Jarrett.
Brady Jarrett, yes.
Brady Jarrett, strong run.
Gee. Oh.
They get a lucky penalty, get out of a bit of trouble there.
Okay, Trent Taylor's now back up in the back play. We can see coming back up now. He's stretching out, but he was in a lot of pain there, Craig. Certainly not stretching out.
Yeah, I think if I was playing for North, I'd be aiming a little bit of attack at young Trent at the moment.
Luke was trying to get him off then, so interesting thing. Who would go to fullback if Trent comes off? There's a few lightly carried. Do you take Brendan Parry out of the centres and put him at one, or you throw Liam Mack there? And
I think Liam Mack is probably, he's got a little bit more speed, and I think the advantage of having Brendan in the centres, mate, after the last couple of weeks, he's just been really strong there. I think you want him in the line.
It's not a penalty there. Probably decision time. Did they take the penalty? No, they took a quick tap, and they're on the attack again, the Cowboys. Ferguson again running forward. Very strong, very deceptive.
They don't want to tackle him.
Will they take
him? He's got spiders on him, Ray.
Head towards centre field.
Good run, Ethan. As you said, Mick, we're still waiting for Ethan to show a bit of magic. Here goes Ferguson again.
And guess what?
Held up on the line.
Oh, Ethan's getting a little bit more involved, but I think at some stage he'll inject himself. And
Cowboys still in possession.
Will need to be aware of it.
Going down the blind again.
Ethan to the right, puts it on the toe.
I'll get the ball back.
Nice again, little dab in behind the line there by young Ethan.
Yep.
Just looking there, if Ferg had been a little bit taller, he might have been able to reach out and get that ball over the line, but not to be. Again, playing a very strong game. Co-coach in Sean Ferguson.
Mate, he's just been a great player in the division over the last, 10 years. I played a grand final with him in 2008, so he's been around a long time, Sean Ferguson. Actually won a grand final with him, with Sean Ferguson, 2008 at the North Tamworth Bears.
And that'll be a turnover. That'll be North Tamworth ball 30 metres out. I was just going to say before Blanchy kicked that, if he gets hold of it, it could run dead.
That's the breeze.
That's
the
best result.
That's the first time we've seen that happen all game.
Yeah, that's the breeze.
Well, ladies and gents, if you're just seeing that, that was a dropout that's gone 80 or 70 metres.
That'll do.
70 metres and over the sideline. Well,
that's mathematics from Tamworth High.
I can't count, but I can lift heavy things.
Kevin Anderson's here as well. Kev, grab that microphone, mate. Let's throw you in for a bit of a comment. What's happening?
Yeah, look, I think, again, whoever's going to use this breeze the better in the second half of this second half is going to get the edge here. And we're starting to see North Tamworth do that with that dropout then that went, 50, 60 metres, and they've just got to start to look for that 40-20. And
went
I think,
70 metres, Kev, actually. Sorry.
70 metres, yeah, sorry. Sorry about your maths there, Craig.
It's, what school?
Just a little shorter than that. I only got to year 10, but so North's back on attack again. I just think whoever's going to use the breeze, get some 40-20 in a tiring side in defence, will start to cut through.
Smoodle again going up the middle.
Big run by Josh.
Talk about spiders on you. Ben Jarvis up the middle.
Big Benny Jarvis.
They've nearly dragged him over the line.
Yeah. He's been asked to go back and play at 12 metres.
Surely not from there.
Another great run.
Cowboys need to rock up.
Ethan Collins.
Blanchy into dummy half. That's dangerous.
Blanchy forgot that he had to go to dummy half.
There's a penalty. Will there be a bin? No. Do they take the two? They keep going.
No.
Grand final.
It's grand final time. Let's score some tries, boys.
Away they go. Benny Jarvis again.
Straight at Benny Jarvis again. He's going to punch one through the middle.
Did you see that dummy? One of the best.
Yep. He's fooled everyone.
Okay, we're about 2 to 3 metres out. Blanchard forward, dummy half again. Sheridan. Yuripi again.
Yuripi unable to find a hole. Straight to Sherrod to Josh. Josh pushes off one, goes again at him, goes right.
They're gone. Oh, he's dropped the ball.
He's lost it.
Good tackle there. Great tackle there, Brady Jarrett. Forces the mistake from Josh Schmiedel.
There's a question there, though. He did get he got taken high. There's no doubt about that. An arm wrapped around his neck as he was trying to break through from that. So there might be an opportunity here for a turnover here.
Unfortunately, we can't go to the box to investigate that one, Kev. So
just looked like a little high from here.
It did look high.
Cowboys food. Just under 23 minutes remaining. North Tamworth leads 16-14. Nice clear run.
Brennan Parry, he great little horsey right foot step to make a half break and loses the ball.
Okay.
Very expensive mistake. They're looking a bit tight out there, Mick.
Yeah, well, I think the pace of the game is probably starting to wear on the sides. Talking to Luke Sheather, the referee at halftime, he thought it was a fairly quick game. Mm. And yeah, I think just this little bit of a lull here is it's really starting to tell on the side. So for me, the team that makes the least errors obviously will probably go on to win from here. But I think it's obviously, again, you know, stating the obvious, field position, the longer that North Tamworth can stay down here with the wind, the better chances they are. Dungown's got to find a way to get to the other end against the wind.
Tell me this, Mick, 20 minutes remaining, both teams showing a little bit of fatigue. Is it a matter of just simply take a big deep breath and just tough it out, or do you put your foot on the pedal and try and get that break?
Well, I'd be trying to maintain my energy and intensity. I wouldn't be locking up just yet.
No.
Obviously, with that win, you don't want to go too expensive and risk forward passes that we've seen in the earlier grades today. But
Jake McManus going forward.
There's still 20-odd minutes to go.
Mm. All right, Craig, bring them home. North on the attack.
Yeah, North on the attack with a good run by Jake Bennett.
He's been solid.
Yeah, he has been, mate. Young bloke, as we said earlier, he's had a great year in first grade.
Coming wide, and the ball's gone down.
Spills it. Ethan Collins spills it on the second.
Cowboys bring
that's
it out.
Another good run. Great run by Ringers. Ooh. Ryan Ingram up the middle. They just need to complete a set here, the guy. You know, both teams dearly need to complete their sets. Hold some form, complete your sets. Pretty simple game. Brandon Parry, another strong run.
Cowboys standing very flat.
Cody Burns about to take one. The whippet, good shot. And Sean Ferguson up the middle. He'll find those eight defenders as he does.
That man is amazing.
Unlucky not to beat that one, but he's limped out of that tackle actually.
Probably
the maestro. He'll be back into his in goal. He'll run it back out. Beats the first.
Good tackle.
And good tackle.
Hang on now. The scary here, Sean Ferguson, limping in back play.
If you notice, you've got Scott Blance and Sean Ferguson both on struggle street a little bit. That last tackle that Blancey did on Cody Byrne, he's reeled out holding the shoulder. And then you've got Shawnee Ferguson.
Clay Fred.
They're both very important to their team, both. Neither side could probably lose, you know, could afford to lose either of those players.
So the 14 Clay Frendon.
Great run, good run, Josh Schmiedel.
Coming towards the sideline, but Craig, as you can see, Ferg might be hobbling, but he's not making his way towards the sideline. He's going to tough it out.
Kobe Bone up the middle, nice shot. Again, Brady Jarrett. Blanche out, puts one high. They're not going to try and catch that, but they'll let it bounce.
Ooh.
It's a bit of a mix up at the back with Trent.
I'll tell you who'd be doing a tough out of everyone on the sideline, boys, and that would be Lukey Taylor.
Sean Ferguson's just come off. Clay Frennan will replace him. Clay's another guy, another young guy that I've watched since he's been a young guy, good young local representative.
We'll keep our eye on Sean Ferguson, see exactly what the medics do. At the moment, he's just toughing it out on the sideline on his own.
Clay straight in the action, takes a hit up on the second tackle.
It's that leadership on the field now, Craig, that they're going to... who's going to step up and make
Cody
the calls?
Cody Burns take another one. He's doing an amazing amount of work out there for such a, you know, as Mick Schmiedel said before, such a light frame, mate. He's done a heap of work in this game. North get the ball back. 45 out.
your North boys.
With Sean Ferguson coming off the field, this is where Matty Wilson probably needs to step up a little bit and take some leadership. But you also got Trent Taylor, who's played a lot of good rep footy at the back, could take a bit of leadership as well and guide him around a bit. Not having Ferg is a massive loss for the Dungowan Cowboys. They're
looking at the...
There's a penalty.
I'd be taking 2 points.
Okay, they're looking at a calf, just looking at Sean Ferguson on the sideline. They're actually rubbing a calf, the back of the knee.
He's opted to take the tap. Mick Smeadle, the super coach.
That surprises me.
Reckons that they should have taken two.
Again, that's three times
they've
down.
They've been down here twice now and turned away with nothing. Let's get something, get reset and start again. They'll probably make a goose of me here and go and score.
Sheridan, the Europe, geez, he's strong.
That's three occasions they've knocked back the kick to go for the play.
And now got a knock on in the ruck. So,
okay, not good. Craig, from where you can see Ferg on the sideline. Are they rubbing or they're strapping?
Mate, they're strapping him up at the moment. He's got a left knee problem.
Okay. That's probably not as bad, where you can actually strap it up and maybe get you through the next...
It looks like a lateral meniscus to me, Ray, actually.
Good work, Dr. Power.
Good run, Tex DeVita. Punching one out from Dungowan. Goes Ethan Arzakles.
Arzakles. And it is Arzakles. It's funny, Australian names.
What was that tandem we talked about, Craig?
Lateral meniscus, actually. I've done a few myself. Shout out there to Shammy Wentworth. He knows what they're all about.
Hey, tell me you had about four specimen bottles at home with meniscus in there, a couple of medials in there.
And my son's got my hamstring, actually. That's no lie.
Here
great
we go. Through the
now.
Middle.
Ringers pops it to Trent Taylor. Trent Taylor's going to try and sprint with that left hand thigh. Heavily bandaged. Gets tackled short.
This is where they take advantage now. What can the Cowboys do? Only a matter of metres out. They'll go to the left. Come back inside.
And he's held up over the line.
Change over.
Clay Frendon.
Take it. Should have taken.
You're probably right, Michael Schmeadle. They probably should have taken the two, get the ball back and then beat it back with this wind. They would have been straight back up here north, but they opted to try and have a go and lost the ball. Now they've got to work out of their own 20.
Just while we're fighting our way out of there, boys, we talked about Luke Taylor sitting on the sideline here as the co-coach. What an incredible performance we're expecting from Jada Taylor tomorrow when she makes her debut with the Roosters NRL women's team. Congratulations, Jada. Incredible feat. What a magic lady. I can spill Mick when we're on the group a number of games that she's played up here in the ladies' league tag and the like. Dynamic. But her commitment to the game and to move forward, absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, she played a league tag grand final a couple
inside
of
inside the 40, inside the 40, guys.
That's another 40, yep. 20 from...
It's just short.
Just short.
Yeah, she played down on Werris Creek?
No, with Dungowan. She played a grand final against North Tamworth.
Yeah?
But they lost to North Tamworth that one, and then she went off to school in Sydney and started a bit of a rugby union career and then got snapped off, obviously, by the rugby league. Which is good because, they're a league family, so...
I remember watching Jada play since she was about 6 years old and, she was absolutely disappointed when they stopped her playing. I think they get to a certain age
there
when
was,
you're
yeah.
girl and
we
you can't
with
play.
That. Yep.
And they stopped her playing, but, mate, her rise has just been phenomenal and, what a great bloodline. Her father was one of the best players in the group, very strong, very quick. He actually went to the Canberra Raiders as well as a young guy.
Well,
so.
He came home because of a broken leg.
Yeah.
Luke came back and played with us at West Emirates.
And he's had a dodgy knee for 20 years, hasn't he? See him running around. Again, he'd be doing a tough sitting on the sideline. With Ferg coming off, Lukey would have loved the opportunity to go on the field and play some footy. And those days are gone. Sorry, Luco. Okay, it's Cowboys on the attack. We're going to the left. We've got 14 minutes remaining.
14 minutes, and Dungowan just seemed to have had the best.
North's leading 16-14 again when the ball bounces. Cowboys have got it back again. What can
like
they
we
do?
Mentioned earlier, the wind is against Dungowan, but they're playing the better footy. They seem to have the upper hand across North at the moment. They're playing it down the other end of the field.
And again, a change over there. Even with the kick, there was no change of possession at all. 13:30 remaining in the second half. The Group 4 Rugby League Grand Final, Dungowan, North Tamworth. Kevin Anderson, pressure time.
Yeah, it was. And I think, you know, when you look at when Anzakalis then put it up, it swirled all over the place and everyone let the ball drop. They did. No one had a crack at trying to catch it, which just goes to show how nervous they are at making a mistake at this time. So blokes are now sort of starting to hang back a little bit. But now's the time, I think, to really put the pressure on, you know, with 15 minutes to go, 2 points of difference, and we've just had another turnover. So
no, that's a penalty now. Penalty now. Jeremy York taking the ball forward, but they've actually got the Cowboy player for holding someone back. So it's now a penalty to North Tamworth.
So again, North Tamworth go on the attack and pump it on the sideline.
16-14, 12 minutes to go. This is the win or lose.
This is it.
Time for both teams. Let's see what they can do. It. York punches one up into the middle.
So this is probably about the eighth time that North Tamworth have been down into the Cowboys' half and they have not had a reward. So
at all.
You know, when you think about when they get close 20 metres out, if a penalty comes, they've got to take the 2 points to put that four-point buffer. At the moment, 2 points leading at the moment. As they yet again get to 22 metres out, on attack, and they start to swing it left again. On it, full on attack here with back North Tamworth.
Liam Ball's gone on too, switched straight into hooker.
Yep.
That's a nice change at this time of the game. You know, young guy, a bit of speed around the dummy half. Congratulations, Liam, on making a first grade team this year.
At 5 metres out.
Ethan Collins takes one up, back to Liam Ball.
Last tackle.
Puts it on the toe. And he stretches out.
It's got to be a knock on. No way.
He thinks he's scored
having a look.
It.
No way.
He's having a look. He's awarded it.
He has absolutely great play, Liam Ball. Short little grubber. Trent Taylor just left it that little bit too long.
Well, I wish we had the video screen here to have a look at a replay of that. No doubt they'll be watching replays of that particular incident for the next couple of weeks. But that was very touch and go, but the try's been awarded.
Yep, I've just had a quick look at the replay, Ray. It looks like he actually did ground the ball.
Just for those people out there watching live at home, Liam Ball is Steve Ball's son.
Yes, that's correct. Yep. And Nicole.
And Steve and Nicole, and I think Steve might have captain coached North at one stage, Craig.
Yeah, maybe under-12s or something like that he did. Good player, mate, and a great sportsman in Tamworth, great hockey player, and also Nicole's dad was is a life member, Bobby Wilkinson of the North Tamworth Bears, so he'll be up there above.
And I think they've got the scoreboard at North Tamworth is named after Bobby.
Absolutely, and he'll be up there watching the game, so good on you, Liam.
You blokes know the breeding of everyone. Okay, we're now with just on 10 minutes remaining, 20 points to 14 with a kick to come for the North Tamworth Bears.
And Ferguson's about to re-enter the game with a dodgy meniscus.
Okay, at the moment 6 points, could go to 8 points. This will test the skills of the Dungowan Cowboys to come back from this. I'd love to see that replay again, Craig.
Yes.
Again, yep. If that's the case, big effort to get
the trainers have done a great job out there today too. I've seen
patched him up.
Yeah.
Again, for Liam to score that try, that'd be a
Christian Brooks, mate. He's in great form out there today.
Craig, going back to that try, that'll be a moment the young fella won't forget.
Mate, you know, to come on at that stage of the game and to fill such an important position like the hooker. Obviously, once he goes in there, their number one player, Scott Blanch, moves out into the first receiving position. So, yeah, it's one that he will never forget. And if they go on to win it, mate, I'm sure that he'll be shouted plenty of beers.
I think Blanche is actually playing 13 because Ethan and Cheryl are both still out there. So I think Blanche will be playing as a loose forward,
yes. Do you think, Michael?
Something like that. He's pretty loose, but yes.
Yep. All right, 9 minutes remaining. Score now 22-40. It's that 8-point buffer now, not 6 points.
Ferguson's back on and into the thick of it, gets the first tackle.
I don't think 8 will be enough. I think there'll be another twist.
Another nice run, nice tackle. Jake Vost, Scott Blanch with the ball.
If I'm Paul Boyce on the North Tamworth bench, I'm a little bit more comfortable than 6-point lead.
It's got Josh Smeedle on the right side, goes left. Kobe, actually Jake McManus.
Again, we said at the start of the game, Craig,
with all the clubs involved today. Dungowan picked up a win in the ladies' league tag. Gunnedah in the under-18s. Moree in reserve grade. And if North Tamworth do go ahead now and take out the first grade game, it'll be basically four different clubs have taken away the championship titles today.
There's a lot of footy left, Ray, I think, mate. With still with 8 minutes to go, anything can happen sitting at 22-14.
Crowd's now getting vocal.
Well, so to Ferguson. Ferguson, another strong run up the middle. Pops it outside to Ringers.
A bit of a...
Ringers to run, young Josh McLaughlin.
Kobe Bone and Ferg having a bit of a wrestle on the ground.
Out to Tex. Terry Tavita makes a nice break. Oh, great tackle there. Number two, Aston Constable. Great tackle from behind.
Here's their
possibly
chance.
A try saver. They come back right, Dungowan.
What do they do?
Burns to Ethan to Trent. Trent to the winger.
They're going to push him out.
Hold him up and they're going to push him out. No.
Oh, they've gone for a... they're penalised. So Cowboys have got the penalty.
Yeah, I think very lucky, mate. Very, very lucky. Liam Mack pushed over the sideline there and I think he... there was
back to Ferguson. Seven minutes remaining.
Trent Taylor in the middle, steps right.
Where's Ferguson? Keep your eye on him.
Ferguson
he's
on
the 17.
Right.
Here he goes. He'll go through, dummy. Oh,
it's knocked down by Jake Bennett. Probably lucky he knocks it down. If he doesn't...
that's a try.
Young Brady Jarrett, or young old Brady Jarrett scores one.
He's actually not that old. He's only 28, I think. But that, you could see there was probably a little set play there where Ryan Ingram dummied to Ferg inside and Brady Jarrett sitting one out. So it was... was a make or break play by Ethan Collins, wasn't it, really? Like, if he doesn't tap it down, Brady Jarrett scores untouched.
Yeah.
Rugby union, that's a penalty.
They still seem to have momentum out here on that wing for the turnover, Mick. I don't really think that was a penalty, but, I'm no referee, you know.
Well, the point being now, they need this converted try, but they also need extra points on top of that.
20 out, Dungowan to feed the scrum.
Ferguson down the blind. He's had a go on his own.
On the short side, Ferguson loses the ball.
I don't know. I actually take that as a North Tamworth player had his hand on the ball. It could be a knock-in against.
What he's ruled there is Kobe Bones knocked it back, and when Sean's gone to pick it up, has knocked it on.
Again.
Yeah.
So you are a referee.
Whatever it is, it's a loose carry, mate, at the end of the day. Yeah. It's a loose carry.
You are friends with Gus Gould too, eh? You're coming out with some of his.
I'm sure Gus is out there. Hello to Gus. Guess. He's probably watching the game from somewhere.
What's his favourite song? Don't talk to me about that.
North Tamworth march it back out again.
How long to go on that
5 clock? 5 minutes. Five minutes, 29 seconds, Michael. Josh Schmiedel.
So this will be...
he'll be a contender for man of the match if they're lucky enough to get a win.
Ball's down.
Loose carry, another loose carry from Liam Ball. Drops the ball. 20 out.
We do have five to go. Craig, your thoughts on a man of the match at this stage, even with the game still in balance?
I still think the game's in balance, mate. It'd be pretty hard. There's some strong players out of there, but obviously, Josh has been one Europe for Norths. Then I think Fergs. There's been some really nice touches from Brendan Parry out wide here.
Cowboys.
Trent Taylor has been amazing out there injured today. Cody Byrne, nice little hit up there.
Ted, like to see him in the gym over the off season.
Plays well over his weight. Brady Jarrett takes another hit up. Nice
going
hit up,
out wide.
Offload.
There's another penalty now. Again, the North's scrambling defence has been very good this afternoon as well, but there's another penalty. What can the Cowboys do now?
Having a bit of a wrestle over there on
That's not all too bad for North Tamworth. They don't mind these breakers and play it through the top down, but Dungowan have got to come up with something special here. I think they've got to look at the Ethan Anzarkles and the Trent Taylors, the Cody, the Brandon Parrys
that
come
to
up
Fergan,
with something.
Back to Burnsy. Burnsy gets tackled, 10 out.
Will they go back to...
they'll come.
Yep, they've gone back.
They'll go to the left.
Oh. Guess what?
And it's a knock on, guys. The knock on in the middle. Oh, Jarrett gets pushed into the post. and number 17 comes over the top. He's
there's a couple.
I think it's just a little malay, guys, to tell you the truth.
Luke hasn't called time off, so you can't. Referee hasn't called time out, so. Down the clock, what the time out with the referee. It's as everybody can see, it's blowing up here a little bit. The referee has yet to call time off.
Looks like they're all going to the bar.
The Dungowan bench would really love it.
It's been a great game up to this point, guys, and 3 minutes 32 to go. They'll break up their little indifferences here, and they'll get the game back going again.
I'm not sure how or why that all started. I think Brett was a bit unhappy with the no try call. Obviously some words were exchanged, and then we went into a push and shove.
Yeah, a little bit of push and shove.
Is the clock still ticking?
No, the only winner out of this at this stage, and they've just stopped the clock, is the North Tamworth Bears. It's wound the clock down. We've got 3 minutes.
He's just gone time out now. So.
No, they've stopped the clock before. 3:32 remaining on the clock. You'd hate to see some players be into this. You'd say, listen, brother, fellas.
Oh, I think you'll find you put one from each side just to settle this last one.
Just to even it up, you reckon?
Well, I think so. I think just with what happened there, I think he doesn't want the game to end in a spectacle, let's say. So I reckon one from each side will go to the bin. Thank you. And let's play the last 5 minutes.
Well, Craig, if you were a referee, wouldn't you just go, okay, fellas, we know how you feel. Let's get on with it. Stay on the field.
Yeah, look, I think sometimes you have to give some in the bin, as he's gone. Just done.
I can't believe
Sean Ferguson, the 17.
I don't think it'll finish there. I think you'll find it. There'll probably be one from North Tamworth go.
And I've got to tell you, Ferg ran about 15 metres to
He was very concerned about his players.
I'm going to say to protect the big fella.
I think he's just run and jumped. He didn't do anything. There was plenty of action going on.
There was nothing. You know, I played a lot of footy with Ferg, and I can guarantee he can't fight. So he's obviously just there to.
I wouldn't like to fight him. Well, I think North Tamworth a bit lucky not to get somebody.
Are you serious?
Somebody sin bin. I thought they probably.
And the penalty goes to North Tamworth.
Now he's got time out again, so he might find another one for Dungowan.
Someone's been sent.
Well, guess who? It's the big fella.
Brett Jarrett.
That's Brett Jarrett. He's obviously mouthed off at the referee.
He said something that he shouldn't have said.
And
because,
it is bad. You do not send
it's a
off
shame
a
for Brett. Frustration.
Hang on, there's the referee.
He's a good bloke. He's a good coach of our academy sides. It's unfortunate for him.
I just listened back to what he said. All Brett said was, mate, how could you do that to my mate? And he's been.
Anyway, North are going to take the kick for touch here. The game will go on.
Three minutes remaining,
and North Tamworth lead 22-14, about to take the hit up. Goes Kobe Bone into the middle. No, passes it off.
Boys, if it does go the way it is now, and it's a 22-14 win to the North Tamworth Bears, from a Dungowan point of view, you could not but think the season's been an absolute cracker. You may not have got the big title, but it's been a cracker of a year.
Mate, like I said previously, they've come from the wooden spoon last season where they had a draw and a win. They're probably going to lose this game by 8 points.
Yeah.
They've still got to be
good run. Josh Meadle puts it on the toe.
I'm not sure what Josh is doing there, but. They've got to be commended for what they've done, and they got the reserve grade side into the grand final as well.
Yeah.
Last year, I think the reserve grade made the semis, I think. But for their first grade side, you know, to go from wooden spooners to grand finalists and possibly lose by 8 points is phenomenal. And I think Sean and Luke Taylor, the coaches, have got to be patted on the back.
It's actually been ruled as a knock-on by the Cowboys. He must have kicked it into the Cowboy player, Josh Meadle. They've knocked the ball on. They get the feed. North Tamworth will get the feed.
It's going to break up here again. And it's the Jake McManus having a shot at Matty Wilson.
Matty Wilson's maybe a little bit cranky. There's not much in it. Let's play the...
Jake's actually quietened him down. No, it's not.
The referee.
It's very unlike Matt Wilson to react to something like that.
Kobe Bones in the middle.
Young chief.
And Kobe Bone, there's no surprise that Kobe's in there. He loves that stuff. But for Matt Wilson to react like that, something. Cause it's not Matty's go. He's reacted to something that was said.
Well, you know, at the end of the day, they've got 11 players on the field. They've got to do the best they can. So they've just got to stay out of the rubbish at this point.
Down the blind. The ball's gone.
Sherrow picks it up, makes a nice run back into the defence.
1 minute 14 remaining. And the ball's down.
Josh Schmiedel drops the ball on the first tackle.
Could have cost him the man of the match. 1 minute remaining. Scoreline is 22-14. North Tamworth leading the Dungowan Cowboys. Kevin Anderson, your thoughts?
Yeah, just disappointing for the Cowboys. They had all the momentum up against the Breeze and they had a fair crack at their line and tempers flared and a bit of frustration came in and two now on the bench and, you know, now they're playing two men down. So disappointing end, I think, for the Dungowan Cowboys.
Who can, nice run
and
there,
now they've just knocked
the
on again with just minutes to go. So, you know, I think it's been a great game but disappointing for the Cowboys just in the last 5 minutes. You know, valiant effort by Ferguson. He's had a cracking game and no doubt he'll be pretty cranky with the way that it's ended up as well as he's walking up.
Just see Sean Ferguson making his way to the North Tamworth bench now. Just to congratulate the North Tamworth guys. Full respect. Yeah. Great game, Sean Ferguson.
Craig, the North Tamworth juggernaut continues on.
Yeah, mate, but as we said, you know, and Kevy just said the same thing. Dungowan had the ascendancy, mate. They had the upper hand. I think for, you know, 70% of the second half.
Hopefully nothing silly at the end of the game.
Nothing silly. Well done, North Tamworth win the...
Bit of frustration.
2022.
Congratulations to the North
Group 4
Tamworth
Grand
Cares.
Final.
22-14. Group 4, first grade grand final.
Okay, folks, well, Craig, Ray McCoy, Craig here, power with you. We've got Kev Anderson here as well.
Congratulations.
A 22-14 win to the North Tamworth Bears over the Dungowan Cowboys. And what has been an absolutely cracking day here at Dungowan. The early results in reserve grade, Moree 22 defeated Dungowan 18. In the under-18s, the Gunnedah Bulldogs 28 defeated Farran North Tamworth 20. And got the day off for the ladies' league tag, the Dungowan Cowgirls winning 12 points to 10 over the North Tamworth Bears. Craig, a bit of a wrap-up.
Bit of a wrap-up, mate. I thought it was very close in the first half. Either side could have won it. You know, Dungowan scored the last try just before the second half, and they went in, and I think they played 70% of the game in the second half as the better team and in the better position. Unfortunately, you know, a couple of indiscretions at the end of the game probably might have cost their Dungowan's opportunity, and by then there was only a few minutes left. But, you know, well done to North Tamworth. You know, they made it, they scored points when it counted, and they've ended up winning the grand final, so congratulations to them.
Kevin Anderson.
Yeah, look, I thought it was a great game. Dungowan certainly had their chances. I thought they should have taken a couple of penalty shots at goal when they had the chance, but they chose to try to go for the points today and just got away from them, I think, in the last 15 minutes of the second half. But I think today, you know, when you look at... when you look at the Cowboys, I thought Josh Schmuda played pretty well. And Scott Blanch again for the North Tamworth Cowboys, for the North Tamworth Bears. The captain played really, really well. And Trent Taylor for the Cowboys. I think Sean Ferguson played his heart out. There's no doubt about that. And I think Tevita Pasili always was dangerous when he got the ball in his hands. But, you know, full credit to North Tamworth. They stuck at it. But I thought Dungowan certainly had their chances and could have gone their way today.
Totally agree, Craig. As we look forward to next year, even at this early stage, with Sean Ferguson and Lukey Taylor leading the Cowboys, we're hoping they'll stick around next year, whether playing or simply a coaching scenario to actually mentor those other players to come through.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, I agree. 100%.
Totally.
Sorry, right, mate.
That's it. Yeah, that's comic on the super coach.
He's right.
I switched on. Thanks to everyone out there for listening and the live stream. Bloke people out there listening.
2022 first grade rugby league grand final.
Okay, we'll wrap it up now. Everyone's going to have a chat now. Craig, thank you so much. Great to work with you again. To Folmac TV and everyone involved, and certainly to our sponsors that have made this all available today. We thank them, Craig.
Yeah, thanks, Ray. Thanks, Kevy, for joining us. It's been great again. And at the end of the day, football's rugby league's the winner in the country, mate.
Great to have footy back in the bush. Well done, boys, and great to see him back.
Thank you, guys. Ray McCoy, Kevin Anderson and Craig Power. Thank you. We'll catch you again in 2023.
Cheerio.
Once again, can we ask the two first grade teams to make their way over to the presentation area, please?
program.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, really need to get these presentations underway. North Tamworth Bears, if you can come over, and Dungowan Cowboys. While awaiting, big thanks to our major sponsors of Group 4, Kennards, Winnigully Childcare, Tui's, and West Entertainment Group. Really appreciate that support. We can't run rugby league without sponsorship. And there's massive money tipped in from those four organisations, and we really genuinely appreciate it. Have the two teams please to come over to the presentation area. Just to begin our presentations, I'd like to welcome to the stage Rob Ferris from Tui's. And Rob would like to say a few words, and on behalf of everybody here, we'd like to thank you for the major sponsorship for Group 4. Rob, over to you.
Thank you very much, Jeff. Ladies and gentlemen, before the presentation gets underway, I'd particularly like to thank you for coming out week in, week out, to support group football and particularly group 4 rugby league. Our sponsorship is only made possible through your support and your responsible consumption of our brands, namely Tui's, 4X and Han Superdry, amongst others. So a really big thank you. Without your support, like I said, it's not made possible. To you, Terry, and your committee, congratulations on the way you've guided and steered the group this year after a few difficult years gone by. It's great that the group is in very good hands, so we thank you for that. And to Dungowan in staging the grand final here today, not everything went your way, but you can be really proud that the ground is picture perfect and it's been a fantastic day. So I just thank you one and all. Thank you and God bless.
Thanks, Rob, and I promise to drink as much of the Han Superdry this evening as possible. First of all, to begin proceedings this afternoon, can I ask the captain of the Dungowan Cowboys, Sean Ferguson, to come forward and to say a few words, please.
I'd like to congratulate Northies on a great game. Always a good every battle, eh, whenever we play. All the best in the future. Well done, Boise and the lads. I'd like to thank the sponsors, make everything is what it is. Without yous and all that sort of stuff, we couldn't do what we do. To the little community of Dungowan, he's pretty solid, eh? Massive effort to get the ground here, looking this good like you do. Between players, committee, farmers, everyone puts in, sponsors, to all that, it's a credit to you. To our lads, our massive club over there, been a great year, been a very memorable tour. Couldn't ask for a better bunch to hang around, train with. Dave, you'd be best bucket, mate, and sorry, Buzz, but. Yeah, it's all right. Gumbles, anyway. Thanks, all the best. Hey, have a beer and get around each other and have a laugh. Cheers.
Well done, Bernie. Thank you very much. And before we ask North Tamworth Captain Scott Branch to come forward, I'll hand over to our local state member, Kevin Anderson, who will announce the man of the match.
Thanks very much, Jeff, and congratulations to both teams. What a great game, and Down certainly had their chances. Well done, Northies. Go the Bears on this occasion. Certainly came out here today and took a full advantage of the weather conditions. I think the ground, considering the amount of rain we've had, was picture perfect. So well done to the groundsmen, well done to Dungown Rec Reserve and the committee. They've done an outstanding job. I thought it could have gone either way today, but the man of the match in the 2022 Grand Final was the fullback for the North Tamworth Bears, European Jacka Williams. Well done, mate.
Very good. Well done, Europee. And can I call for the captain of the 2022 Group 4 Rugby League Champions, North Tamworth Bears, Captain Frankie Scotland.
Obviously, first and foremost, I'd like to thank the group, the officials today, and all throughout the season. Without you guys, there's no game. Dungown, massive effort, three teams in the GF. Great day out here. I think it was five or six deep on the fence, so well done. Great season. There's no secret, probably two tightest knit clubs in the group, and that's why we're here today. To our guys, to our club, all our volunteers, the narrative about North is that they're the big club, the rich club. We're not. We just work hard. We work for everything we've got. We've had our ups and downs this year, a couple of losses in a row early. We worked hard out of that. We've had a couple of wild weeks right at the end of the season. We worked hard out of that, and we deserved it today. Well done, fellas. Yes, man of the match, number one. Ashton. Missa. Jeremy York. Well done, Yorkie. Carrie Carey. Damien Scott. Ethan Collins. Mitch Sheridan. Stay up here, boys. Jacob Menace. Benny Dahl. Joshua Smeadle. Well done, Smeadle. Jake Lost. Jamie Bain. Liam Ball. Jake Bennett. Hey, you fellas. James Cooper. The truck, Big Tevi. Thanks to everyone for today.
And of course, the coach, Paul Boyd.
Yeah, get a photo down there. Yeah, go down there.
Just wanted to get the photo there. Once again, big congratulations, Dungown Rugby League Football Club, for the show you put on here this afternoon.
Back on the road again, the big black bears up. Back on the road again, the big got a victory now.
everybody. Congratulations, North Tamworth Bears. Once again, well done, Dungown Rugby League Football Club for the show you put on today. Big thanks to Terry Sarakis and his team for everything they've done to make 2022 the raving success it is. That's it for 2022. Travel safe, everybody, and we'll look forward to another successful season of the greatest game, rugby league, in 2023. Take care.